All right, Inigo, welcome to PopAsia.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
Is it your first time to Australia?
It is my second time in Australia, but it's my first time to finally be able to go around a bit. I was working the first time I was here. Right now we're working, but we're also able to go around and visit new places. It's my first time in SBS, so thank you so much for having me today.
Oh, no worries. Yeah. You know, you've been extremely busy lately with, you know, your new songs like Options. Mm-hmm. Tell us a bit about your musical journey for anyone that hasn't heard you before.
Well, I was born in the Philippines, and I moved to the States when I was 8 years old. My dad is an actor. He's a celebrity in the Philippines, and, you know, all my life I've wanted to be the exact same thing, but my parents were just not for it. You know, they're like, no, we don't want you to do that. You know, we want you to do something else, because they want to protect me from the world of, you know, show business and how, you know, crazy it can be sometimes for a kid. So they brought me to the States, and I grew up as a normal kid, normal school. But music was something that I just naturally gravitated towards. You know, like, no matter what I did, it was always music that I was just always in love with. And I've been in the Philippines now for 5 years. The first 3 years of my career, I was acting. So mainly focused on just making acting projects. And on the third year, I was finally given the opportunity to make my first album with my first single, carrier single, Dahil Sa'yo, which is, you know, till today, still my biggest single. I'm just honestly grateful. You know, I'm working on my second album right now. I've been able to collaborate with different producers from different places. You know, I was able to work with Harv, who is currently Justin Bieber's musical director for his tour, and also his upcoming album. And it's just honestly been a crazy ride. I was able to collaborate with Wenji. You know, everything's been so much fun, and I'm honestly just enjoying the process. You know, we're doing this crossover thing, bringing our music, OPM, original Filipino music, globally. And, you know, I'm honestly just so excited for music, because, you know, like, with the rise of K-pop, you know, I mean, Hispanic, Latino music has been around since like forever, and of course English. I feel like OPM, you know, I feel like we are able to do that as well. We're more than capable of, you know, sharing our music, and music is a universal language. You know, no matter what language you speak, we can share whatever we have.
Yeah. What kind of music can we find on, say, your iPhone?
All sorts of music. Honestly, I listen to everything. I listen to classical music. I listen to, like, I love country music.
Oh, really?
I love, a lot of pop, you know, like I listen to R&B. There's Daniel Caesar, there's Rule, there's Shawn Mendes, Hunter Hayes, Bazzi, Bieber, you know, Migos, you know, like hip hop.
Any K-pop in there?
Oh yeah, dude. Oh yeah, big time. There's, of course, Big Bang, there's BTS, EXO, okay. GOT7, yeah. 17, Blackpink.
Out of all those stars, who do you reckon you draw the most inspiration from?
Honestly, like I there's this one person that I was just kind of impressed, and I kind of wanted to be that kind of level of, you know, discipline. It was Jackson Wang from GOT7.
Yeah.
This guy is from Hong Kong, speaks, like, I think 4 or 3 different languages, and he dances so well. He can rap, he can sing, and I'm just like, wow, that is so cool. He can host, and at the time, I was starting my hosting career for a bit. I hosted some stuff, and I would watch his videos. You know, I wanted to learn how he does it, how he's just so energetic and he lets himself lose, you know. And I just wanted to have that same, you know, kind of effect on other people as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who would you love to collaborate with?
Oh, man, there's a lot.
Jackson Wang first.
Jackson Wang, of course, yeah.
Jackson?
I mean, GD is like, you know, that's like impossible. But yeah, GD is like one of those people that I really look up to. There's a lot. Kai from EXO.
Oh, okay.
Yo, yeah, so I was able to shoot a music video in Korea recently, and the director directed one of some of their music videos, and I was asking him, I was like, yo, so is Kai like really nice in person? He's like,
is
yeah.
Is he around here?
I was like, can we meet him? Like, no. But he was talking about how he's really talented, really down to earth. So it's nice to hear that, you know, from people that has worked with these artists.
So obviously your dad's extremely popular as well. We were just wondering if you knew or have watched many of his movies.
Oh yeah.
So I'm going to show you a bunch of your dad's movie posters. I was wondering if you could name the movie.
Oh my gosh. That's hard, because I'm not good with posters, but let's do it.
Okay. All right, here we go.
I'm going to embarrass myself. I hope my dad's not watching.
Okay. That one.
Paano kita ibigin?
Correct.
I was there. I was part of the movie.
Oh, hey.
I had like a pictorial, and I was like the young him.
Okay, yeah. So it's hard to forget when you're actually in the movie. Okay, what do you think of that poster?
It's romantic. It's very sensual, and she's a very talented actress and a singer as well, Miss Regine Velasquez.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right. Ta-da.
Last night.
It is last night.
Oh. I was actually I was there while they were shooting this, and so you know I would kind of watch them, how they would you know try to get into the character, and I enjoy honestly just watching them work on projects like this.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Ta-da.
Oh shoot.
I forgot the name of this movie.
Is it Northern Lights? No, it's not. Oh, wait. This is with Yen Santos. Oh my gosh, this is recent. Is it Northern Lights? No, it's not. It's not Northern Lights. Is it? Oh man. Wow.
10 seconds.
It's not Northern Lights. It's not.
Northern Lights? It is Northern Lights.
Oh, it is Northern Lights.
I just wanted to see you struggle with that for a bit. Well, because there's Northern Lights in the background.
Yeah, but I thought it was like...
Any memories from this?
They shot this abroad, so no, I wasn't there when they shot this, but I was there at the premiere night.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so that was cool.
Wow. So when you're on set and your dad's acting, what kind of stuff would you do just hang around?
Honestly, I love watching the whole process of them getting into the character, and I like hanging out by the director's booth and seeing how the director works, you know, and I honestly love just seeing them do it. You know, it's crazy because it's different when you see it on screen and when you see it like in person happening. It's like a whole different experience, a whole different scene going on. Yeah. You know, I act as well, so you know, I get a lot of inspiration. I get to, you know, see what I can apply to my own. Something was ringing. I get to use what they do as well whenever I have projects. And my dad honestly helps me out so much in terms of singing, acting, or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, Mr. Dream Boy.
It is.
Yeah,
Mr. Dream
I love
Boy.
This movie.
Okay.
One of my favorites. Yeah, he had to like play, I think, 10 different characters. So that was kind of cool to see my dad portray like different versions of this Dream Boy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you ever watch these movies at home, or do you primarily watch them when they're premiering?
Usually when they're premiered, but you know, it's... My dad, honestly, he would not choose to watch his own films at home. Oh. I feel like it's... I mean, I wouldn't do that either. Like, I wouldn't watch myself. But yeah, usually when they're premiered or when they're shown on TV.
Okay.
Yeah. OTJ.
Yeah.
On the job.
Oh.
Yeah, so this is cool because one like memorable moment was when I went to Best Buy, and this was the very first Filipino film that was available on Best Buy in the States. So it's kind of like I had a proud moment. I was like, this is my dad's movie.
Yeah.
So that was cool.
I can't believe you said in the past that during school people didn't believe that you were the son of your dad.
Mm-hmm. I had a tough time first, second, and third grade. I had teachers that would tell me, you know, like, bring your dad to school or else we won't believe that he's actually your dad. Even kids would tell me, you're not actually like this superstar son. And as a kid, I didn't understand, you know, I didn't understand why I had to go through it.
Yeah.
To me, it was like, my dad works, you know, I see him doing his stuff, but I didn't understand why people had to doubt or, you know, I was just a kid that, you know, I was just trying to survive. I was just trying to live. I was just trying to study.
Yeah.
And that's partly why I migrated to the States. And I'm very honest. I'm thankful I did that because, you know, I'm more appreciative of things that I experience.
Yeah.
And that's all, like, the whole misconception of people. I don't want them to think that just because I'm his son, I had an easy way. Like, it was honestly so tough having to, you know, deal with that as a kid. It was traumatizing in a way, you know, having your teachers kind of doubt you when they're supposed to be people that you look up to. And I don't want to speak badly about them. Like, I love my teachers. You know, you guys are great, and I learned so much from you guys. But, yeah, I had those experiences back when I was younger.
So how did you solve those problems? Did just one day you're like, ha-ha, here's my dad?
No, I was a weird kid. To be honest, I would always find ways to just entertain myself. And I think that's why I turned into music as well. You know, I had a hard time, I guess, connecting with other kids. You know, I didn't understand why I had to be made fun of for a situation I didn't really choose to be in. You know, it was, I was always friends with older people. You know, I was always friends with the cafeteria ladies, with the janitors, with the teachers. I was always friends with older people. And I guess, in a way, you know, I feel like that's why I like talking. You know, I like chats and just really communicating. Yeah.
I've heard you say that your dad didn't want you to pursue a career in entertainment. Mm. In the future, would you let your kids pursue a career in entertainment?
What I've come to realize is if you have a passion, if you're like just extremely passionate about one thing and it's something that you just naturally gravitate towards, even if you try other things, I feel like it's meant to be there for a reason. You know, it's a purpose, you know, it's something that was given to you because you are meant to use it. So if my kids in the future are extremely passionate about one thing, you know, and if it's right, you know, if it's not to harm them, then yeah, of course, I would allow them to pursue whatever, you know, career they'd want.
Yeah.
I mean, easy for me to say, right? Because I'm not in that situation yet.
I've also heard you talk about, you know, wanting to spread Filipino music all around the world, bring it to the Grammys. Mm-hmm. What other steps in the future are you making towards that goal?
Well, you know, I mean, right now, this is the first time we're doing this crossover thing. And the opportunity that's been given to me is honestly such a huge blessing. And I've always just dreamt about, you know, being on other radio stations or like around the world. Like right now we're doing this. And honestly, this is all a dream because I was just doing this in the Philippines before where I thought I would be stuck in. And, you know, what we want to do is really bring our music globally. You know, and I feel like now is the time because, you know, technology with social media being there to help us promote our music and to share it internationally. I feel like we are more than capable of really spreading our music to the international stage. And, you know, I feel like right now people are just more open to different cultures, different music, you know, with K-pop just blowing up and really just taking over like the music scene, just, you know, like crazy. It's honestly the perfect time to share your music. Mm. And, you know, like, it, not everyone will like it. Not everyone will enjoy your music, but at least you're able to share it.
I've got 5 fast questions to ask you.
Rapid fire questions.
Yeah. Number 1, horror movies, yes or no?
Yes.
Favorite song ever?
Oh, wow. All I thought of was best song ever by One Direction. Oh, no. Phil Collins, You'll Be My Heart.
Oh, wow. Wenji's best feature?
Our song, is that, does that count it, Mr. Nice Guy? Yeah. I'm the one who's featured on her song.
Yeah, so that's her best feature.
Yeah.
Or best physical feature.
Oh, feature, that's what you meant. I'm so... Yeah. I guess just her dancing. Honestly, I'm so impressed. Everything. And Wenji's so nice. Her face, her everything.
Okay. Who's the better singer, you or your dad?
My dad is a better actor. Let's leave it at that.
Love it. Apparently your nickname is it Phuket? What does
Phuket.
It mean? Phuket.
Phuket.
What does it mean?
Pogi, where it came from, it means handsome in Filipino. And my dad would call me Pogi as a little kid. And then, like, through the years, he just, like, I guess, started coming up with his own version of the word Pogi, and he turned it to Phuket. So it's like a different way to say it. But it means spogi, which is, it means handsome, which is, okay. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, nice. If you could be in any movie franchise, what would it be?
Spider-Man.
Wow. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we could totally see you as Spider-Man. Yeah. Do you have a girlfriend?
I don't.
Okay. Star sign.
Sorry?
Star sign.
Virgo. Is that what it is? Yeah. I'm a Virgo. Yeah.
BTS or EXO?
Why you gotta do me like that, bro? Why? Like, so the XOLs and the armies?
You can say both.
Both. Yeah, I can't choose.
Don't want to call
I'm
anything.
A fan of both, honestly. Okay. But I've never seen BTS live in person, so hopefully one day. But EXO, man. Kai, he's my bias.
Can you sing a bit from your latest single?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Catching Feelings?
Yeah.
But every time you tell me that you love me, every time you tell me that you want me, making me feel and think it's the same inside. I will keep it to myself, but I gotta let you know that I'm catching feelings for you. I'm catching feelings for you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah, we could sit here and listen to you sing all day.
Thank you.
Inigo, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me today. Yeah.
Yeah. Please come back.
Yeah.
Yeah, anytime.
Hey guys, this is Inigo Pascual for SBS PopAsia.